Alright, yo, what is going on, everybody? You guys got the Barkage of the Hidden Games Village here today, and in this video, I'm going to be sharing with you guys some tips for staying in shape during the holidays. We've got Thanksgiving tomorrow, and then, of course, you know, Christmas is coming up, and kind of in between these holidays is a time where people tend to, you know, kind of fall off with their workout plan, you know, kind of eat a lot worse than they normally do. So I thought I'd give you guys some tips that I've used in the past to avoid this and stay on track with my fitness goals. So the first few tips I'm going to be giving you guys is kind of based on dieting on these specific days, such as Thanksgiving or Christmas, where you know the diet is just going to be off. So the first thing that you can do that I'd recommend and that I have actually tried before is just to intermittent fast on these days. So for example, you would start eating on, let's use Thanksgiving, you would maybe start eating at, you know, 3:34 whenever the dinner is, and then, you know, just eat until maybe, you know, like 10 p.m. or something, like a 6-hour window there. It doesn't really matter your window. You can do, I recommend like maybe like a 6 to 8 hour feeding window if you're going to be doing the intermittent fasting method. But yeah, that's just a good way to make sure that you don't, you know, overconsume a bunch of calories, because yeah, it's really just a good calorie restriction tool, the intermittent fasting. And then number two, which is also a pretty good one and also kind of basic, is just, you know, limit yourself, you know, maybe only pick, you know, one dessert, maybe only have like one piece of bread, just limit yourself to like one serving of everything. Because I know for me personally, especially like on Thanksgiving, it's like one cookie will turn into five, you know, one piece of bread will turn into six, and you know, I'll just have like just like a bunch of servings of a bunch of stuff that I really don't need to be eating, but it tastes good. So yeah, the first thing, and yeah, obviously, you know, it's not easy, it does take, you know, some willpower and discipline. But you know, if dieting and, you know, staying in shape were easy, you know, we wouldn't really have a problem with, you know, obesity in the world. So it is tough, it's going to take some discipline, some hard work, but you guys can do it, trust me. And then the other thing I'd like to touch on is one day of bad eating is really not as bad as people think. You know, one day of bad eating is not going to ruin, you know, your past months and maybe even years of hard work. So, you know what? If you don't want to do any of the other two methods and you just want to eat however you want for one day of the year, go ahead and do it. It's really not a big deal. You know, you see people that are like, oh, wow, man, I gained 10 pounds on Thanksgiving. Okay, no, you didn't. And maybe, okay, maybe you did, but it's 10 pounds of water weight, not fat. So one cheat day is not going to be bad. But the thing that tends to happen is, you know, one day turns into a bunch. Like, it's like, oh, it's just one day. And then the next day there's like a family gathering and they're like going like, oh, it's just one day. And then, you know, they spiral out of control. So if you want, you know, one cheat day of just eating whatever you want is completely fine. But if you don't want to do that, you know, you can use the intermittent fasting method and then the serving limitations that I discussed. And then, so the second thing I want to talk about in this video is, of course, how to stay on track with your workout plan. Because a lot of times, you know, people, they just say they don't, you know, have time during the holidays. It's a busy time for a lot of people. Personally, for me, I haven't really understood that, because it's a time where people tend to be off work and off school. And it's like all year long, while you're going to work or while you were at school, you were training. And now you don't have to do those things and you can't train all of a sudden. So I've never understood that one. But one way to, you know, really stay on track is, number one is think of maybe a goal that you'd like to reach before the end of the year. You know, me personally, I'm trying to do full Maltese before 2021, hoping to get that. Now, your goal doesn't have to be that, obviously. You know, maybe try to learn muscle up, or like maybe some other muscle up or handstand or something like that. Because yeah, if you start training for those two moves now, you definitely would be able to do them. So yeah, some sort of goal is one way. And then the other thing, I know I made fun of these 30-day workout challenge videos in one of my past videos a couple weeks ago, but I do think like maybe starting like some sort of fitness challenge or 30-day thing right now would be a great way to hold yourself accountable for training, you know, because you can see, you know, you're marking off the days of the calendar that you're working out, and then if you maybe skip a day, you'll feel bad about yourself and, you know, continue to just, you know, keep working out. So, and then of course, after the 30 days, you know, keep going, but I think that would be a good way to hold yourself accountable for that. So, with that said, that's pretty much all the tips I have for the dieting on the specific days where you know you're going to eat unhealthy, and then for staying on track with your workout goals. Let me know if you guys have any things that you like, any strategies that you guys like to do on these days. And if this is the first video that you are seeing from me, definitely consider subscribing. I normally do calisthenics workout training, which is bodyweight exercises. And thank you all my current subscribers, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Deuces.